back here at the Pope after St. Francis Brooklyn defeats LIU in the 44th Battle of Brooklyn, completing a season sweep. Marc Ernay at center court. We've got Chauncey Hawkins to my left and Glenn Sanabria to my right. We'll start with the MVP of this one. A big first half for you, young man. 17 points. You came out on fire tonight.
Yeah, I know. I don't really know what to say. It's just we kind of had to have a sense of urgency, me personally and as well as the team, coming out from our last game, you know, a really tough loss. And the way the conference is, you know, you lose one game and you could drop to, like, the bottom of the standings. So we understood that. And, you know, LIU was right there with us, so we just had to come in with a certain mindset to come out and get the W. So.
But you especially had a hot hand. And did you come out with the mindset to shoot, shoot, shoot?
I don't know. I hit my first one, and then I got an open shot for the second one, and I made it. So I got into a little bit of a rhythm, and then just started going from there, and was thankfully I was able to make the shot. So.
Talk to me about defensively. The job you guys did on Raekwon Clark came in averaging over 20 a game, and he was well below that most of the night.
Yeah. You know, Yaya started off him on him good. Yaya's been doing a good job of that, just getting on their best player. He's a tough matchup because how lanky he is. And then we just kept throwing guys at him. And the same thing we did with Wagner. You know, we threw a bunch of guys at Saunders. So it was the same type of thing, and it worked out for us. And, you know, but he's a good player, though. But we were able to hold him in check for today.
You mentioned the Wagner game. That was a slog in the first half. I think 19-17 at the intermission. A lot of points scored in the second half. Tonight, a much different story in the first half. But you guys were down most of that half. Keon hit the big three to give you the lead. You finished it with an 8-0 run, yeah. And your three capped it off.
Yeah. It was a rat race today. Even the ref was coming up to me telling me, can you guys slow down a little bit? We're a little tired over here. So I was like, yeah, I know. It's a fast-paced game. So, but it was a fun game to play in today.
All right. We had a red out. It's Valentine's Day. The T-shirts, great crowd on hand. What was it like for you on the floor?
It was a fun experience. You know, this is my last Battle of Brooklyn to play in, and it was a fun time. And I'm just really thankful to get the W. So.
All right. We wrap up the homestand on Saturday. What are you looking for then?
Just trying to get back at CCSU. You know, they beat us on their home court, and we got to go out there and take care of business and try to just keep moving up on the standings as we finish up this last stretch of the season.
All right, congratulations. The MVP tonight, Glenn Sanabria. Let's turn it over to Chauncey Hawkins, who had a big second half with 14 of his 16 points. What changed for you after intermission?
After intermission, I just – sometimes in the first half, I like to just feel the game out, see how the game's going, how I can be effective. And seeing Glenn in the first half just being so aggressive – It sparked an interest in my mind. Hey, I should be aggressive too. Because every time we win, it's two out of the three guards are really on. And today, we all three played a really good game and came out with the win. So just seeing him in the first half was like an inspiration.
You guys only play close games in conference here at home. How important was it to pull this one out?
Oh my gosh. The importance level rose once we lost our last game at FDU because we're at the end of our homestand. We just really want to finish strong, and we want to stop being a high and low team. So now that we got this win, it just adds more fuel to the fire. We got an amazing rivalry, the 44th meeting between us. It's just amazing. I'm glad we came out with it, and it allows us to have a lot more motivation going into conference play.
You were having a lot of fun in the first half as you guys went ahead for the first time tonight, playing a little air guitar.
Of course, like Lance Stevenson does with the Lakers, I had to. Coach gets mad at me, but I just love encouraging the guys, having fun with it, because at the end of the day, it's basketball, it's a game, and we all love it. We have a great opportunity playing Division I, and why not have fun with it?
All right, so the second straight Thursday, you guys complete a season sweep of an opponent. Last week, Wagner, tonight, LIU. You've got Central Connecticut coming in on Saturday. You guys owe them because they beat you at their place.
We do. We owe them tremendously. Hopefully, our floor is a little better than theirs. It's a little slippery in there. But, they're talking a lot of junk. We just got to go back out there and play the game we know how to play. Start lining our offense up with our defense and just keep closing them out, because Coach really emphasizes that in practice.
Chauncey Hawkins, congrats on the win. Glenn Sanabria, congrats on the win. 44th Battle of Brooklyn. We're going to welcome in the coach, Glenn Braica, who has aged another 10 years tonight. In another nail biter here at the Pope. I was just joking around. You guys don't play any runaway games here at home. They're all nail biters.
The whole league's like that. I mean, it's a very balanced league. I think every night is like this. So there's nothing you can do. You got to come and you got to play every night. If you don't, you're going to get beat. And you got to play well just to give yourself a chance.
That was a much different first half tonight than you had against Wagner a week ago, where that was a slog. This one was a horse race.
Up and down. This is the pace of the game. Even a ref came by the bench and said, wow, the pace of this game. They earned their money tonight because it was very up and down, very, very fast-paced game.
They were in control for most of the first half. You guys closed it out on an 8-0 run. You got two big threes. The one from Keon put you in the lead, which turned out to be the last time you would trail all night. And then Glenn hit another big three right before intermission.
Yeah, you know, I thought they were the more aggressive team in the first half. And we were yelling at our guys. I broke a clipboard and, you know, whatever. But our guys responded, and they really got going. We started to make some shots at the end of the first half. So I think that kind of got us going and got us some juice defensively and everything. And the second half, you know, I don't like the way we started it again, the first two possessions, but then we got going. Then we were all right.
Not going to keep you long. How much did it mean for you to win this, particularly the Battle of Brooklyn?
I'm from Brooklyn, so it's nice to win, but I want to win every game. So it's a great tradition. And, you know, obviously they won it last year around this time of year. So, you know, we were lucky to get it back this year. But, you know, we may play them again, so who knows? So, you know, it doesn't really matter at this point. We got to be prepared for Saturday and then what's beyond.
Hey, last two questions before we talk about Central. What was your strategy on Raekwon Clark tonight? Because you held him well below his season average.
You know, I thought Yaya set a good tone at the beginning of the game and his length and everything, and he was locked into guarding him. And I think when you play against a player like that, you got to be all in and you got to be total focus. You know, he's a terrific player. I mean, he's really tough around the basket, great driver, you know, gets to the free throw line. He's really good. So, you know, we trapped him a couple of times in the post. They got a layup once. But, you know, all in all, you know, I'm pretty happy with the way we came out of it because he killed us the first game.
All right, finally, we turn the page. Look ahead to Central on Saturday. You owe them a bit of revenge after they beat you up in New Britain.
Central's playing really well. They're very talented. They got a great player in Tyler Cole and some other guys who can score. So it's going to be another war. You know, we got to regroup. We got to rest our bodies tonight and tomorrow and focus. Keep our focus for Saturday and come out and be ready to play again.
Coach, congrats on the win. Now 9-2 this season here at the Pope after a win in the 44th Battle of Brooklyn over the LIU Blackbirds. Back with Coach Rorson to wrap it up after this timeout on the Terrier Sports Network powered by NEC Front Row.